Would you believe me if I told you that Mars was once very similar to Earth? Perhaps there was once life on Mars, but currently this is not the case. Over the decades, it has evolved and is now a totally different planet from our home. It is possible that Mars wasn't always the dry, cold, barren wasteland it is now. Some scientists paint a picture of the red planet as having a shallow sea covering much of its surface, making it look more like our own planet. The red planet is a dead planet, but it wasn't always that way. According to rovers and satellites, the dry Martian plains originally flowed with rivers, which pooled into vast lakes and possibly fed into a global ocean. Ancient Mars, like Earth, may have provided a comfortable climate for any emerging microbes. After billions of years, Earth has remained a blue marble, whereas Mars has devolved into a desiccated husk of its former self. While most of the desiccation was caused by the catastrophic loss of Mars's atmosphere, the planet managed to retain some of its water. Even that small supply, though, is dwindling. Mars's atmosphere may have had a different composition back then, and it was likely thick enough to support a liquid water ocean. So, how did Mars get to where it is now? Researchers have discovered that water molecules are slipping through a protective atmospheric barrier considerably more easily than predicted after repeatedly skimming the highest reaches of the Martian atmosphere with an orbiting probe. When the solar system was still young, baby Mars probably looked a lot like baby Earth. Both planets had electrically charged molten metal cores. The liquid currents swirled through the metals, forming magnetic barriers around the planets. During the sun's turbulent youth, these magnetic fields repelled both solar wind and electrical assaults from periodic flares, shielding planets' emerging atmospheres. Also, water poured down on both surfaces as thick layers of air enveloped them. On the other hand, Mars was far too small to have a realistic chance of remaining habitable in the long run. It cooled down more quickly than planet Earth. The core solidified. The magnetic barrier that had been protecting the atmosphere broke down. The sun also blew most of the atmosphere away. Most of the liquid water on the surface of the planet quickly followed it into space. The Mars atmosphere and volatile evolution MAVEN satellite, which has orbited the red planet since 2014, has been tasked with restructuring this 3 billion year history. According to a study released in 2016, researchers found a hint that Mars's ancient atmosphere may have been rich with oxygen, manganese oxide. Because this compound occurs in wet, oxygen-rich settings on Earth, the researchers believe that liquid water and an oxygen-rich atmosphere played an important role in forming these deposits. Another team of scientists observed strange ripples in the sand on Mars. These ripples were unlike anything seen on Earth, and they appear to be unique to Mars. But what can ripples say about an ancient atmosphere? According to the scientists' findings, a thin atmosphere altered the way winds move through the sand, resulting in these distant characteristics. These characteristics have been fossilized in rocks dating back 3.7 billion years. As a result, these ripples could be used to determine when Mars's atmosphere might have significantly reduced. But where has that atmosphere vanished to? Because Mars is smaller than Earth, holding on to its protective blanket was likely more challenging. Mars's atmosphere was probably stripped away by radiation from the sun, due to a lack of a strong enough gravitational pull to keep it attached to the planet. MAVEN spacecraft is currently orbiting Mars and is studying changes in the planet's atmosphere, particularly its solar activity variations. The researchers are interested in learning more about how solar flares, radiation, and coronal mass ejections, CMEs, interact with Mars's atmosphere. The Sun, on the other hand, hasn't been cooperating. While the Martian boundary was never meant to be a perfect seal, MAVEN's measurements indicate that it leaks significantly more than expected. According to researchers, seasonable warming, annual regional dust storms, and decadal superstorms have led Mars to lose a lot of water during the previous billion years, enough to cover the planet in a global ocean 2 feet deep. That's only a fraction of the water Mars has lost over its history, enough to flood the planet in an ocean that is dozens to hundreds of feet deep. But it's the main reason the planet is still drying out. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.